Okay, so we've had this stitch down, and I'm gonna again snip those to the other side over there. And do the same thing here. I just leave some little bit longer pieces, and then we can just recycle that thread. And then here's that beautiful little image sticker from Finnebar. And what I did is I just kind of did like a little belly band. So you can tuck, you can put that there. And then we have this beautiful trim. It's going to be in the shop. And I want to put some of this here as well. And I want those roses to be a little bit centered somehow or another. That'd be pretty. We got this little score up here. We can put that there. I like to build. We have this, we have this, we have these here. And I cut a scrap of here, this applique sitting here looking at me like, what are you going to use me? Okay. Some of that. And where my cheesecloth went. I don't know where I threw my cheesecloth, guys. I'm sure it's in this massive mess called the craft room, right? Just kind of get it together, gather it, put that together, put that there, put that there. Get a button that will look pretty there. Maybe something like that will stick out. And let's little snippets of stuff. Okay, so let's go ahead and lay this down. And I'm gonna probably do it. Yeah, let's do it on here. I'm not putting a thick coat, as you can see. If you're worried about it seeping through your fabric, just take maybe a piece of wax paper or a little plastic bag or something that you don't want, if you don't want it to seep over, like. So what I'm gonna grab is I have, let's see, one in here, I have stuff. See what I have stuff. I know I got stuff here. I'm fine. What can I use to prevent that from sticking? Not that it will, but I think I got it pretty much. I need my grungy wax paper. Here we go. I love that grungy wax paper. You guys have seen me use that thing in so many projects. It's like unbelievable. But I love it. And I'm one of these days I'm going to use it on something once it's had its share of, it's seen enough grunginess. I might tear a little piece and use it for this little project here. I think it's doable. Let's clean this mic. That way it's just kind of not sticking. I'm closing our little pocket up after so much work we've put into our work, right? Alright, so then we're going to lift her up a little. She's going to go right there. Isn't she beautiful? I think so. Remember, you want to make sure you don't seal up your little pocket deal thing there. Okay. Now we can glue these. Alrighty. And then one over there, one over here. Yeah, I think I like her there. I do want her up here. Let's see, maybe up here would be good. Let's put it up there, because then we can put a little message on the top. Like so. Let's get one of the chipboards. Get some of my coffee, guys. I've sewn these. All we have to do is distress them. This one already that we need to use. So that's probably going to go in here, like so. But let's wait till that dries up. Oh, we were supposed to use this, weren't we? Weren't we? We forgot. Still put it here. So, let's go put it there. I think it'd be perfect right where it is. Okay. Make sure that's not gonna go anywhere. Some more one of these chipboard pieces. And maybe get a sign or something up here. Oh, that's too big. I like pouring these out because I got my little basket here of the other stuff. Because these stuff, you know, oh, that one's perfect. Let me go with that one. That way we can pour it. I like to be able to pour and see what I have to work with. I like to spread out. I don't know about you guys, but I love to spread out. You guys like to have your mess spread out. comment below. Let me know. Do you get your stuff spread out? I know I do. I have to see it all. What am I working with? It's my theory. What am I working with? What do I have to work with? All right, we're going to put that right smack right there. Par avion. Yes, 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 yes. Okay. So for par avion, we have a little stamp here. And we're just going to stamp. Yes, we're going to cut that. We are. I'm going to stamp a little bit with our stays on. Hot mail. Hot diggity dog. Hot dog, hot dog, hot diggity dog. Mm-hmm. There you go. I have a little. I have my window open. Make sure that's dry before we move on. And I think we can snip these off now. And yeah, this is going to be available at the store. I'm just waiting for that shipment to get in. It's coronavirus, even stateside, because I normally order my stuff from the States. But even, I mean, even stateside, everything is like slow in shipping. Like extremely, everyone's like extremely slow in responding as well, because I don't know what the deal is, but everyone's even slow. We're going to probably put that big old button because it keeps smacking me like, you're sitting here, you've got me on my desk, on your desk, and you're not using me. What's the dealio? The dealio is that we're going to pop you right smack there. And let's make sure we really get this in here. Right? Because we don't want our stuff to fall apart. All right, so that's probably going to have to make sure we get that in there really good. Good contact. Friend over here, the hot glue gun. It might take a little bit longer. So it's like a little belly band. And again, like I said, I got the wax paper just to prevent it from sticking to the other side of the fabric. Because I can peel it off from the wax paper, but it'd be hard. So then we can tuck that in there. And I can go right in there and finally put that one there. Like so. Mm-hmm. Not pretty. And that little snippet, little trim there. I like that. So that's that one. And just trying to kind of turn that one over slightly. Moving along. So what I'm going to do is I will, from this point on, I'm just going to probably maybe fast forward. I know you guys like to watch it in real time, but it takes a little bit longer. To get things down. So what I'm going to do is probably fast forward, maybe. I don't know. If you don't see the video, fast forward, because then I just thought, oh well, it is what it is. But I'm not sure if maybe fast forwarding would be the best thing at this point. I'm not sure, but oh, I like this. I just think I might be going for something else, though. We have this. I like that there. Yes. I'm going to put that there. Yes. Piece of Amy's little piece of like doing little collages. A collage. Not like that. Let's glue this one down. That way we'll know. We'll know because it's a little wrinkled, but you know. Okay, stretch it to get its. It how we want it. Right. Notice I did not put it in the center, only because Fabri Tac is wonderful. It is. I love it for my paper because it dries up really nicely. And fast, it won't work, but on fabric it will tend to leave a little bit of a yellowish stain to it, and I don't like that. So what I try to do is in the areas that it won't be so noticeable, and this one's a little bit more permanent than the what do you call that? That glue gun that we love so much. Okay, so that's why we're going this route here. Left a little bit hanging. Then we can, I'm not sure why my little distress dinghy is all the way to the other side of my desk. When I need it in front of me, right? Coffee again. Then Amy's paper distress it. And we have this fabric tape. We can also use some of this. we're going to do first. Alright, we're going to go here, here. Maybe we can go over here so we're not interrupting that fold. That fold is a little bit on the, let's see, did this glue down? Yeah, we can remove this little baby out now. There, better. That's better. And then we can probably put that there and maybe use that as a little tucking mechanism. So let's do that. Let's put the other one on the opposite side. Put this one there. Put that one there. And I'm probably going to stitch it. I'm probably going to use some of this. Let a little piece hang out. I'm going to probably stitch it. Let's see if I can pull these out. Jeez. No, you're not sticking there. You're not allowed to do that. Alright, slate flat. You guys see me? Nope, you can't. I probably need to close my, I'm going to stitch this around here this way. So let's move this, some of this aside and get the machine out. And let's get the machine to work some magic on stitching. Stitching magic. The cord's all over me. So I stitched it, a little sticky there, and then we're going to put it like so here. I'm supposed to leave a pocket, but maybe we can put the pocket on this side over here. That's what we'll do. We'll leave a pocket on the opposite side. Let's move this down. Now we have like a little pocket over here, and I'm gonna put that there, and I keep forgetting I don't want to put that there. Not what I want to do, May. No, 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 no. All right, let's move some of this junk out of the way. Seal notes. And I'll probably just a little bit on one side. We can use the other for a tuck. So, okay. Dropping everything, guys. Crazy. Oh, we can tuck there. Gonna go on the opposite side. Figure out what do I want there, guys? What do I want here on this corner? And put that there. Oh, that's right. We needed to do that for a tuck, right? That can't go there. But it can. Sorry, I'm talking to myself, and I know you're probably saying we don't hear you, May. Okay. So, thinking that's gonna have that there. We can probably use this here, and maybe, yeah, let's put that there. First, let's distress it. We don't want anything so new. I'm trying to make it look like it's old, right? I'm trying to decide, do I fast forward or do I not? Just show you the finish end of it. I'm deciding, guys, as I'm trying to assemble, I'm deciding, what do I want to do? What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? That's too big. Too big. Put a tag like that there. Oh, yeah, we can do that. We can do that. But I'm thinking of this because it's a really cute assemblage. So we're probably going to go with that right there. I don't know. You guys are probably saying that looks kind of goofy, maybe, but I like it. I feel comfortable with it. Here. No, I can save that for something else. You could probably save that for something else too. It just looks kind of plain to me. So we need to put something there. That's plain. I don't like plain, guys. But Holtz. We got some of these little stitches. Okay. I like that. I do. All right. Look old. We can probably put the ticket. Field notes. Okay. I'm gonna probably just staple that. That'd be perfect, just a quick staple, because that could be another little tuck mechanism. We're going to use one of the little bowl pins again and cover my ink pad because we don't need that to get dried up. And I really need to find my cheesecloth, guys. I seriously do. I do. Okay. I know I kind of grabbed everything the other day. I was trying to clean up and I was trying to get to my child. Let's see that. Scraps of stuff, so we're gonna probably do that. free that. Button, this button makes everything so cute. And we're gonna go with a green button. Honestly, don't know where I put that cheese pop, guys. Oh, I see it, guys. I see it. Oh, shoot. I see it. It's on the back of my computer. I see it. I just kind of threw things together. I'm paying attention. There. Why don't you glue down, guys? You're supposed to glue down, dude. Dude, glue down. We're not having this today. You're not going to play with me. Alright, so that is that there. That tucks there. That goes there. And grab this tag that we have in our shop. Yeah, let's put something from Tim's collection. And maybe big dude, you're too big, dude. There we go. That little boy looks cute. He looks smitten. But even more smitten if we distressed us. Alright. So when I'm putting things together, I'm just, you know, it's just kind of a winging it kind of thing. I try to coordinate everything as best as I can. Doesn't always go as planned, you know. It just goes. It is what it is, you know. We kind of just go with the punch, with the flow, with the feel. And hey, let's grab, you know, grab this little great paper that we keep, you know, using for so many wonderful projects, and we have not used it. So let's grab that, and we're going to grab Amy's. Use our handy little metal ruler to trim off. It is wax paper, and it's been like coffee dyed, stained. I don't know what we've done through it. We put it through a lot of stuff throughout the course of some of our tutorials. This dressed little boy here. Yeah, too new. I'm gonna make him a little bit appear like he's old, like he's been around, like as old as he looks, you know. He could probably be my grandpa. just tore that up, so we need to distress where we tore up. And just try to collage it together and see how it looks, you know? Perishable. Is this kid perishable? Maybe. Who knows, you know? Can't get any meat with the COVID. He might be perishable. Who knows? It's not a very nice thing to say. But I just try to collage. I don't, you know, don't think about it. Just do it. Just do it, guys. That's the best advice I can give you guys, is the concept of just putting something together. You know, he might be an angel. Right, he's somebody's angel. I'm sure he is. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe he's alive. I don't think so. Not with the clothes he's wearing. I don't think so. It's not possible. That he could be perishable, and he could be an angel. Be a perishable angel. Maybe not. I like him like that. I do like that up there. I do like him as an angel. So I'm sorry, dude. You're going to be a little angel for us here. Probably put some glitter on them if you want. Let's get some glitter up in him. I'm just going to use some stickles. Probably have to let that dry before we attach that on, because we all know how stickles are, right? A little complex. See what I mean about stickles? I didn't mean to do that. Forgot, guys. I forgot. Let's see if the glue gun, hot, not glue gun, heat gun. We'll kind of hurry up, speed that up a little first. I honestly do not like reading a lot. I mean, I think stipples are awesome, but I just don't have the patience for it. Looks like it's drying. Tried. Yep. Oh, still a little bit wet. Darn it. Darn it. Good enough, but you know what? It gave it a crackled look, drying it up. And I like that crackled look. Look at that crackled look. I don't know if you guys can see that. I like the crackled look, believe it or not, I do. Not glittery like it normally would be, as iridescent glittery, but I like that crackled look. So I'm going to let it dry up a little. Take my little... So some of those cracks can pop out more. Mm-hmm. I could have probably made this a little bit more not so new. All right, because we're working on old, and we got a fairly new piece of string, you know. It's kind of doesn't go well. All right. So we're moving it over. And you can probably take a little bit of, like, a gesso or a liquidy paint. See what we have here in the speckles. Some gesso. Alright, let's dry this up a little so we're not getting smudged. Alrighty then. Alright. So, we can tuck this one, hopefully. Maybe. Oh, I think it might be a little bit too big. Yeah, that's going to be big, guys. Alright. Will that one fit in there? Probably not. I worked so hard on that card. Alright, we'll come back to it. We'll find something that'll fit in there. He'll fit somewhere else. We got plenty of pockets that we can tuck him in. Definitely, we can tuck him in here. See? We got plenty of pockets. No big deal. Okay. Tuck that there. We're gonna put that one there. And we're probably gonna need some of those pins. And all right. Oh my gosh, we're going into an hour. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do this off camera and create the rest of this little pretty album and show you the end results. I just have this page. Well, I've got plenty of pages, but I'll just show you what, at the end, I'll show you guys what I ended up doing so that you guys can see what I did. Okay? So just stay tuned for the finished results of this beautiful little journal. And I hope you guys have a awesome Mother's Day. Stay safe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.